Hello everyone! In my previous video, you studied about the Central Highlands. Now let us get familiar with the Deccan Plateau. This is the name given to the southern part of the Peninsular Plateau. The river Narmada separates the Deccan Plateau from the Central Highlands. North of the river Narmada, we have the Central Highlands. Whereas south of this river, you can find the Deccan Plateau. It is a triangular landmass bordered by the Western Ghats in the west, Eastern Ghats in the east, and the Satpura Range, Mahadev Hills, Kaimur Hills, and Michael Range in the north. Part of the Deccan Plateau is also visible in the northeast. They are known as Meghalaya, Karbi Anglong Plateau, and North Kachar Hills. If you move a little further, you can find the three prominent hill ranges from the west to east. They are the Garo, the Khasi, and the Jayantia Hills. Hope the location of all these ranges is clear to you. Now let us know about the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats in detail. The Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats are basically mountain ranges, forming the western and the eastern edges of the plateau. These ranges are called Ghats. Western edge of the plateau is known as the Western Ghats, whereas the eastern edge of the plateau is known as the Eastern Ghats. There are many other differences between these two ghats. Do you want to know? Then continue watching. First, the Western Ghats lie parallel to the western coast, whereas the Eastern Ghats lie parallel to the eastern coast. Second, the Western Ghats are continuous and can be crossed through passes only, whereas the Eastern Ghats are discontinuous and irregular. But why? Because there are many rivers draining into the Bay of Bengal. These rivers break the ghats and make their ways to enter the Bay of Bengal. Third, the Western Ghats are higher than the Eastern Ghats. The average elevation of the Western Ghats is 900 to 1600 meters, as against 600 meters of the Eastern Ghats. Last but not the least, the highest peak of the Western Ghats is Annamudi, whereas Mahendragiri is the highest peak in the Eastern Ghats. Hope you got all the points. Do you know the Western Ghats cause orographic rainfall? What is orographic rainfall? It is a type of rainfall that takes place when a highland, such as a hill or mountain, comes in the way of moisture-laden wind. Any idea what will be the result of this? Yes, you are right. The wind will not be allowed to pass. Rather, it will be forced to rise. The rising air will get condensed after reaching on higher altitudes and will fall down as precipitation. This kind of rainfall is known as orographic rainfall. Now let me tell you another important feature of the Deccan Plateau. Here you will find a black soil area known as Deccan Trap. This is of volcanic origin. Hence, the rocks are igneous. These rocks have broken down and eroded over time and are responsible for the formation of black soil. Hope this is clear to you. So children, let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with the Indian dessert. Do like and subscribe to my channel if you found my video interesting. Thank you, everyone.